Today I will show you typical patterns which can be observed in the ops versus spread plot and how to interpret them. The ops versus spread plot is useful to diagnose misspecification of the structural model. As a reminder, in the observation versus prediction tab, two subplots are available. Here we see the observations versus the prediction using the population parameters, and here the observations versus the prediction using the individual parameters. If the model properly captures the data, we expect the prediction to be sometimes above and sometimes below the observation. If this is the case, then the dots in the ops versus spread are evenly distributed around the y equals x line here in black. How far away the dots are from the line depends on how large the residual error is, and this can differ for large or small predictions if the residual error is not constant. We have more information on this in the feature of the week video number 5. When the values range over several orders of magnitude, it is often convenient to look at the plot on log-log scale. In this example, no misspecification can be detected. And remember that the red dots represent the BLQ data. Please have a look at the previous feature of the week for more information on this. And in addition, it is normal that on the plot using the population prediction, the values are more spread. This is because the prediction using the population parameters is of course more further away from the data compared to the prediction using the individual parameters. And this can also be seen in the individual fits, for instance. I will now show you several examples of ops versus spread plots using the individual parameters with typical deviation patterns for PK models. In the first example, I have used dense PK data for remifentanil that is given via an intravenous infusion. In the data view here, when I plot the PK concentration as a spaghetti plot on log scale, I can see that I have two slopes. So I have fitted a two-compartment model with infusion and linear elimination. If I go to the observation versus prediction plot, on linear-linear scale it looks okay, but if I change to log-log scale, I can see a clear deviation for the small concentrations. The dots are above the y equals x line, so it means that the predictions are too small compared to the observations. Using the highlight across plots, I can focus on one individual and see it in the individual fits here. If I go again to log scale, I can see that actually there is a third slope, so three compartments are needed. So such a deviation in the ops versus spread plot is typical of models with too few compartments. If I now show you the ops versus spread plot after adding the third compartment, it looks like this, the deviation has completely disappeared. In the second example, the data is for theophylline after an oral dose. The data looks like this, and I have fitted a one compartment model with first order absorption and linear elimination. If I go to the ops versus spread plot, I already see a trend in linear-linear scale, and if I change to log-log scale, I can see this smear of values in the lower part of the plot. If I check the times, it always corresponds to small times around 1. This pattern is typical of a missing t-lag. We can also see it in the individual fits. If I zoom on the early absorption phase, I see the missing t-lag. It is good to remember this pattern because with multiple doses and somewhat sparse data, we often forget to look closely at the absorption phase in the individual fits. So if you see this pattern, it is a good hint of a missing t-lag. If I now add the t-lag, then I get an observation versus prediction plot like this, where the smear has disappeared. In the third example, it's a data set for a monoclonal antibody with several doses. I have tried to fit a two-compartment model, so a simple linear model. If I look at the ops versus spread plot, in linear-linear scale it looks okay, but if I change to log-log scale, I can see a deviation for the small concentrations. This time the prediction is larger than the observation, and this is quite typical of a nonlinear elimination not properly accounted for in the model. If I look at the individual fits in this example, I can see the model misspecification also here, but sometimes the individual fits are less clear, and detecting this pattern in the ops versus spread is really a real help. If on this data set I instead use a TMDD model from the library, then the ops versus spread looks like this without any deviation anymore. So to summarize, these are the three typical patterns we can see for PK data. If the deviation is like this, then it's a hint of a missing compartment. If we have a smear like this, it's a hint for a missing T-lag, and a deviation like this for the small concentration indicates a probable nonlinearity to add to the model. Have a nice week!